Sean Spicer is out. Anthony Scaramucci is in. Embattled press secretary Sean Spicer quitting today after Scaramucci, a Trump fundraiser with no communications experience, is named communications director. Spicer's 182-day tenure as press secretary has been rocky from the start.
When I say rocky start, I mean it in the sense of Rocky the movie, because I came out here to punch you in the face.
Well, you know who wasn't laughing at that? President Trump. Now Spicer is gone. Scaramucci in right now. Listen to what he said about Trump.
You're an inherited money dude from Queens County. Bring it, Donald.
You're close to Walker.
All right, that was 2 years ago. Now he really, right now, loves President Trump. Really.
But I love the president. I'm very, very loyal to the president. And I love the mission that the president has. I love the president. I obviously love the country. I love the president.
So here to discuss now, CNN senior media correspondent Brian Stelter, political analyst April Ryan. Good evening to both of you. It's going to be some interesting times. You covering here as our media correspondent, and also you covering from the White House, April. Brian, I want to start with you because we heard the lavish praise of the president, his confessions of love. You know, it's sure to please his number one viewer, and that is the president. But the question is, can he help get this White House out of this crisis mode?
No, I don't think any smooth talker, no matter how smooth, no matter how affable, no matter how slick, can get the White House out of this crisis that it finds itself in. If Scaramucci can help this administration be more honest, Don, to stop making so many misleading and false statements, that would be an improvement. That could help the White House's
credibility. So you're
saying
this is beyond messaging.
That would be very difficult.
He's in charge basically of messaging, right? The problem you think the White House has goes way beyond messaging.
Way beyond
messaging is part of their problem.
But I do think we're going to see Scaramucci encourage the president to give more interviews. You remember what we said this time last year all the times? Let Trump be Trump. Let Trump be Trump. That was the advice that TV commentators were giving to the campaign. Just let the president, now president, then the campaign boss, be who he is. Let Trump be Trump. And that's what we're going to see Scaramucci encourage the president to do. Go out, give more interviews, say whatever you want. Don't feel restrained, even though his lawyers don't want him talking about the Mueller probe. I think we may see more of that from the president.
Yeah. You know, maybe he can, April, and I'm sure people around the country are hoping that he can help this White House in whatever way he can, at least with the messaging. He can't really help him with the investigations because that's not his bailiwick. But Spicer was as combative as Scaramucci is smooth. So I want you to listen to this clip. This is from his press room appearance.
This was the largest audience to ever witness an inauguration, period, both in person and around the globe. When we use words like travel ban, that misrepresents what it is. I've said it from the day that I got here until whatever, that there is no connection. You've got Russia. If the president puts Russian salad dressing on his salad tonight, somehow that's a Russian connection. But every single person, I appreciate your agenda here. But the reality is, hold on. No, at some point, report the facts. Let me answer. But you know what? You're asking me a question, and I'm going to answer it, which is the president, I'm sorry, please stop shaking your head again. We didn't use chemical weapons in World War II. You know, you had someone as despicable as Hitler who didn't even sink to using chemical weapons.
So April, we saw a lot. Wow. You're reliving all of it, right?
Sean's greatest hits.
Yeah. So do you think Sarah Huckabee Sanders is named press secretary now? Do you think that we'll see a change in tone? Maybe not as combative. Maybe not so much, you know, fake news espousing from the podium.
We'll have to see, Ron. I mean, because what they've been doing before is just not working, and we've seen that because Sean Spicer's now gone. I mean, he's been embattled since day one, but he's now gone. And he was one of those on the list that President Trump had a bullseye on. But when it comes to how they're trying to deliver the message, you know, this administration is very much steeped in spin to the point where they contradict themselves. Well, let's say before today. They contradicted themselves. Not only that, they just came out saying things that just didn't make sense in some instances. And then you had a president who would contradict them. So they have to rein in the staff and also maybe rein in the president. And for the president to be himself, that's one thing. But when he goes out there and does the kafefi or says that former President Obama was wiretapping him and some of the other allegations and also the thing about Comey and this tape, you know, I wish there was a tape. That's where the damage is. You can have the best communications machine in the world, but when that principal is just doing what he wants to do, mm-hmm. you can have them meet with the New York Times, American Urban Radio Networks, anyone, Brian Stelter, you. But when he continues to defeat himself, there within lies the problem. You can spin, you can send a message out, but when you continue to do the same thing over and over again, you defeat yourself.
Brian, what do you think?
I think April would make a great communications director. I think a lot of reporters have this same sense. sitting in the press briefing room every day, feeling frustrated by the non-answers and by the spin and by the nonsense, I think a lot of reporters are wondering, can it improve with Sarah Sanders at the podium and Scaramucci behind the scenes? I'm very skeptical. Mark McDowell's being very skeptical that this can actually cause improvements.
Can I ask you and April something? Because we all knew Sean Spicer.
Right.
We all have interviewed him.
Right.
Mm-hmm. He had a lot of political capital. He had a lot of, he had garnered respect from the media. And then all of a sudden, within like a day,
right.
it was gone. What happened?
Trump happened.
That first day.
Trump happened, right, April?
What happened, April?
Yes, I'm in agreement, Brian, yes. That first day, when he walked out there challenging the numbers, size matters. It was an ugly day. You do not use that podium for that. And then he came out there discombobulated, very angry, when this should have been a day of celebration, even though he had women walking around the nation and the world protesting against him. You know, you're supposed to be above the fray, but it showed right there that there was a disarray within that White House.
And what was your relationship like with him? Because you knew him before and others, and did those relationships change?
I knew him before. I was shocked that Saturday. I was shocked that Saturday when he did that. Sean was great prior to, and you know, first couple of weeks he was great. But after a while, when the Twitterverse came in, the trolls came in off of Twitter and said, why is she asking questions? When that base said that April Ryan shouldn't be in the room, the mood changed. And even the president, you know, I had a former White House press secretary call me and say, do you think the president told Sean Spicer to do that about shaking your head? So after that, things changed with us. And I wish him well, but, you know, unfortunately, he lost his credibility in that job, standing up for press. I mean, sometimes going out spinning to the point where you questioned if it was a lie. So, and the credibility issue, we didn't know if we could believe them. I mean, we're always fact-checking, but it was a way bigger issue now with this administration. So I don't know.
I've got to ask Brian, can he get it back? Can he get the credibility back?
I think that's a... I don't have a yes or no question answer to that question yet. I think this White House's credibility is a bigger problem than Spicer's personal credibility. Certainly, Spicer can go out and get a big television deal. CNN notably said today that we're not interested in picking him as a contributor. I thought that was notable. Fox, you could see Fox hiring him or NBC or another network. I could see him rebuilding his public image through a television commentator deal. But whether he can do that or not, the more important issue is this White House's credibility, whether we can trust what the president is saying. And Scaramucci's got a heck of a challenge now trying to improve
that. Good luck to him. And I mean that sincerely. But you know what? If Sean Spicer wrote the book, I would read it. But chances are he probably signed a non-disclosure. So
right now, he's trying to be very
cordial
with
the
president. We'll see if that changes.
Thank you both.
Yeah. It's not going to be a tell-all.
Thank you. Up next, why President Trump's bringing Anthony Scaramucci into his administration, even though the Mooch, as he is known, supported Scott Walker and Jeb Bush in the election before backing Trump.